bellowing their way onto the Blood Bowl pitch, the hulking ogre players of the Fire Mountain Gutbusters are terrifying opponents to face on the Astro Granite. Welcome to this painting video, where we're going to show you how to paint the ogre players of the Fire Mountain Gutbusters Blood Bowl team. Now in this video we'll be painting an ogre blocker, but of course these techniques will work on other ogre players in the team as well. So grab your paints and your brushes and let's get started. So to prepare our ogre blocker for painting, we've already undercoated it here with Mechanica's standard grey spray, which is a perfect undercoat for the techniques we're going to use. You'll also notice we've filled in that slot on the base with liquid green stuff and allowed it to fully dry. And once it has, it's time to start painting our ogre blocker. The first area we're going to paint is the flesh, as it's the largest and messiest part of the miniature. We'll start off with a base coat here of Catachan flesh. So for this, grab your medium base brush. Let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now here we're going to be using our palette to mix a little bit of water in from our water pot just to help thin down that paint so it goes on a bit smoother onto our miniature. Then load our brush up and it's onto our ogre blocker. Here we're applying a nice even base coat of Catachan flesh all over our ogre's skin. And don't forget to hit all the parts of the skin, of course. We've got the torso here, we've got the head, the legs, the arms, and make sure you've got around the back as well. You'll notice as you're applying this base coat, you may need a second coat to get a nice solid colour. Not a problem, let the first one dry, then we'll apply a second coat later on. There we go, that's a nice even base coat of Catachan flesh all over our ogre's skin. Okay, let's start adding some detail to that flesh now. First of all, we'll apply a wash over the top with Nuln oil. Once that's dry, we'll then add a layer over the top again with Catachan flesh. Then we'll highlight the flesh first with Blood Reaver flesh and then Night Quester flesh over the top of that. First of all, it's that Nuln oil wash, and for this we've got our medium shade brush ready. A little bit of paint out of the pot like so, and onto a palette here. Now we're not going to thin this paint down at all, we're just making sure we've not got too much paint on the brush. Just going to load our brush up. There we go, bingo. Then onto our ogre. Now it's a nice even coat of wash all over the ogre's skin like so. Everywhere we just painted the Catachan flesh, apply this now. Now as you're applying this all over the flesh, make sure you're moving the paint around and don't allow it to pull together too much in any areas. You see here, for example, we've got a bit of a pooling going on. Just going to move that paint around there just to make sure it's nice and even when it dries. Apply this all over the ogre's flesh, and once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. Once that wash is dry, we've thinned down some Catachan flesh again, and this time applying it as a layer over the top. This time we're just painting onto the raised areas of the muscle of the flesh. So leave the sunken areas, or the recesses, the original colour we've just painted. With that done, we've now got Blood Reaver flesh. We've thinned it down quite a bit. Now we're applying a highlight all over the muscles of our ogre. Just go around the edges there of the muscles like this. It'll be quite subtle when it goes on, but that's absolutely the intention here. We're just highlighting the very edges like this, helping to define the muscles on the ogre. Up next, we've got Night Quester flesh, and here we're just applying it to very, very tips of some of the sharpest areas of muscle, for example, here on the arm. We're using a small layer brush here for added control. We've thinned it down quite a lot as well, so it goes on really thin. Just take your time with this one, just apply it to the very, very tips of the highest areas, especially around the face as well. Once that's done, it's time to move on to the next stage. There we go, that is the flesh highlighted on our ogre. But there's one thing left to do on the flesh, and that's to add a red glaze onto the lip and around the nipples of our ogre to help make them stand out. Now for this we'll be using Caribou Crimson, and grab your medium layer brush for this. Let's take some Caribou Crimson from the pot and onto our palette here. We add a little bit of water now just to thin it down to make sure it doesn't go on too strong. Just a touch, mind. There we go, that's all we need. Mix that in. Then load the brush up, and here we're just applying this glaze onto the bottom lip of our ogre here, just to help make that lip stand out. There. We're also going to do it around the nipples too, just to give a bit of colour on the chest as well. So there we go, that's the skin of our ogre done. Alright, let's tackle another messy part of the miniature now. It's going to be the metal parts. Now here we're going to start off with a base coat of Iron Warriors, and over the top of that we'll apply a wash again of Nuln oil. First of all, that base coat of Iron Warriors, and for this grab your medium layer brush. Again, let's grab some paint from the pot and use our palette here to add a little bit of water in just to help thin it down. Again, not too much, just a little bit, that's perfect. Then, onto our ogre. Here we're applying a nice even base coat of Iron Warriors onto all the metal parts. So we've got the Iron Fist here, and don't forget as well, we've got the gut plate, we've got the metal parts of the shoes as well, and any other part of the miniature you'd like to be metal. Next up on these metal areas, we're applying a wash of Nuln Oil. And again, we're applying a nice even layer all over. Just make sure we're covering all the areas, but don't allow it to pull too much in the recesses. So there we go, that's the wash dried. All right, up next, let's highlight those areas by dry brushing some colours on. We'll start with a dry brush of Iron Hand Steel, and then a dry brush of Necron Compound over the top of that. Now, normally we use a dry brush for this, but as these areas are quite small and we don't want to hit the flesh, we're actually going to be using an old medium base brush instead for a bit more control. Let's take some Iron Hand Steel from the pot here and onto a piece of tissue paper. I'm going to brush most of it off so we've got very little left on the brush. There we go. Bit more. Perfect. Then onto our ogre. Here, we'll use dry brushing motions across the metal parts like this just to help pick out the very, very edges and tips of the metal areas. You can see there, as we're dry brushing it on, just the very edges being picked out with Iron Hand Steel. We'll do this all over the metal areas like this, being super careful not to hit the flesh we've already painted. Once we've done that, it'll be time for the next dry brush. Then another dry brush on top, this time Necron Compound, and concentrating more towards the edges and ends of the metal areas. There we go, that's the two messiest parts of the miniature done. Which means now it's time to start picking out some finer details. And we're going to start off by painting the shield on our ogre blocker's shoulder. Now I'm going to start here by base coating it with a shabty bone. So grab your medium layer brush for this. Let's grab some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Now here we want to add a little bit of water again to help thin it down so it goes on real smooth. Then onto the shield. Here, just a nice even layer over both the cover and the wood. This little metal part here we're going to paint later on, so don't worry if you hit that right now. Just make sure you're not hitting the metal parts in the middle we've already painted. Just be nice and careful. You'll also find you may need a second coat to get a nice solid colour. Not a problem, let the first one dry, then apply a second coat over the top. So there we go, that's that base coat applied. Alright, let's add some contrast paints now to help add some colour. We're going to use Skeleton Horde on the wooden part of the shield, then we'll use Iandan Yellow on the cover. Then we'll use a Shabty Bone again to highlight both sections. First of all, Skeleton Horde. Grab your medium layer brush for this. Let's grab some contrast paint from the pot here and apply it to our palette. Now with the contrast paint, we're not going to thin this down at all. We're going to use it straight from the pot, but we are going to use our palette to make sure we're not overloading our brush with too much paint. There we go, that's perfect. Then onto the shield. Here, we're applying the Skeleton Horde onto the wooden part of the shield, like so. Now as it goes on, you'll see it's staining it and making it look a little bit like wood. We're actually going to use two coats here. So allow the first coat to dry, then the second one over the top. Then a coat of Iandan Yellow over the covered side of the shield like this. You should just need one coat of this, but again, apply it nice and evenly all over this area. With both those contrast paints dry, now we're in a quick cheeky highlight with a Shabty Bone to both areas. So applying to the very edge of the yellow cover like so, and on the wooden areas like this, we'll apply it to the edge like this as well to those panels, and also flick down a little bit onto the grain of wood to make it look like wood as well. There we go, that's his shield done. Okay, up next let's look at some brown details, that's the leather and the fur on our ogre. We'll start off here by base coating both areas with Rhinox Hide. Then we'll highlight the leather with XV88 and the fur with Mournfang Brown. First of all is that Rhinox Hide. Grab your medium layer brush for this one. Again, let's take some paint from the pot and onto our palette. Cheeky little bit of water, just a little bit. That's all we need. Bingo. Then onto our ogre. Here we're applying a nice even base coat again onto the areas we talked about. So that's the fur and the leather. So look at all the straps here all over our ogre blocker. And don't forget to paint the belt too. And also we're going to be painting the fur. Now there's two areas here. We're looking at the fur around the boots here and also the fur coming out of the shoulder pad too. Once that's been applied, first we're highlighting the leather areas here with XV88. Using a small layer brush here, getting a nice fine line of XV88 along all the areas of leather like this. Then up next, we're picking out the fur with Mournfang Brown. Again, we're using a small layer brush here, picking out the fur like this, just very carefully, making sure we're leaving the recessed areas right outside. There we go, that's the fur painted on our ogre. Okay, up next it's time to have a look at painting that famous white and orange kit of the Fire Mountain Gutbusters. We're going to start off by painting the white sections first, and for this we're using Korax White as our base coat. Grab your medium layer brush for this one. Okay, let's take some paint from the pot and apply it to our palette like so. Now Korax White is a little thicker than some paint, so we're going to add a little bit of water here to help thin it down, make sure it goes on the model real smooth, then it's onto our ogre. Here we're applying a nice even base coat all over the shorts, like so. You can see as it goes on, as we thinned it down, it'll probably need a second coat to get a nice solid colour. Not a problem at all, let the first coat dry and then apply a second coat over the top. While we have this paint out, we're also going to apply to other areas of the model we want to be white as well, such as some armour sections at the front on the belt here, and maybe also some bits on the gut plate at the front as well. This is entirely to your own taste, and you can do it as much or as little as you like all over your ogre miniature. Once that's done, it's time to move on to the next stage. There we go, that's the base coat applied. Up next, we'll be adding some more colours to the white areas by first of all shading it with a contrast paint, Apothecary White, which we're going to mix with contrast medium to help thin that colour down. Once that's done, we'll then add a highlight of Korax White and then another highlight of White Scar. First of all, it's that Apothecary White and contrast medium. Here we've got our medium shade brush again. Now, first of all, we're going to take two brushfuls of contrast medium and add it to our palette like so. Then we're going to wash our brush off to make sure there's no medium left on there at all. Then we'll take one brushful of Apothecary White, like so, and add it onto our palette like this and mix it in. That'll give us a nice thinned down Apothecary White. Then load the brush up as before and onto our miniature. Here we're applying this onto the white areas we just painted before. So again, we're just a nice even layer all over the white areas, and you can see as we thinned it down, it's going on quite subtly, which is perfect. We're going to apply this all over the white areas like so, and once it's dried, we'll move on to the highlights. Next up, we've thinned down some Korax White, and here we're applying it as a highlight on the cloth, just picking out the raised areas like this all around the white cloth. We're also going to highlight those little chits of metal as well if you painted those too. Just highlight the very edges with this. Next up, we've got a touch of White Scar here being applied with a small airbrush, just on the very tips of the cloth here, like the sharp edges down at the bottom. There we go, that's the white done. Okay, let's have a look at the orange next, and we'll start off by painting a base coat of Jacquero Orange, followed by a wash of Fugan Orange shade mixed with Lamian Medium. Then we'll highlight with Bestigor Flesh and Ungor Flesh. First of all, Jacquero Orange. Grab your medium layer brush for this one. And again, we're going to get some paint from the pot and onto our palette. A touch of water here just to help thin it down. Also going to make sure we've not got too much paint on the brush, and a nice point on the brush too. There we go, perfect. Then onto our ogre. Now here it's going on to the orange parts of the miniature. There's quite a few here. So we've got armor panels such as the shoulder pad here and the gauntlet here as well. We're also going to paint it onto various chits of metal around the miniature as well, as we did before. So we've got small chits here, for example. Arm panels here too as well. We're also going to paint the stripe on the side of his shorts too. Just very carefully picking that out here with the same paint. Then, over the top of this, we're applying a light wash of Fugan Orange mixed with Lamian Medium. Here's about 1:1 the mix, and we're just washing it over here to provide a little touch of shading in the recesses. With the wash dry, we're highlighting the orange areas first with Bestigor Flesh. Here we're using a small layer brush and taking our time to make sure we're adding a really fine edge highlight just along the very edges of these areas. Then over the top of this, a cheeky little highlight of Ungor Flesh, which we're just going to use on the very, very tips of the sharpest areas. So for example, these metal gauntlets here around the edges. So there we go, that's the orange part done. But let's finish off that armour now with a white stripe on our ogre's shoulder pad, where you'll put your player number. Now for this we'll start with a base coat of Korax White, we'll draw the stripe on with that, then we'll shade it with Apothecary White contrast paint again mixed with a touch of contrast medium there. Finally we'll use Jacquero Orange again to tidy up that stripe and also to add chips into it as well. First of all, that base coat for Korax White, and for this we're using our small layer brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot here and onto our palette. Now for painting the stripe, we're going to want this to be really thin to make sure it goes on real smooth and we get those lines straight. So I'm going to add a little bit of water here to thin it down and make sure we've got a nice point on the brush too. Then onto our ogre. Here what we're doing is we're just adding a nice fine white stripe onto our shoulder pad here by drawing two lines like this onto the shoulder pad. One there. Oh, make sure nice and straight. Then one over here as well, equidistant. We're using these two little straps at the top here as a guideline. Once those lines are painted in, we'll fill it in with Corax White. You'll probably need a couple of coats to get a nice solid colour. Over the top of this, we're now placing a contrast paint. This is Apothecary White. It's quite a lot of contrast medium here, so it goes on real subtle. Last but not least, we've got Jacquero Orange here again. And if you need to tidy the lines up, you can do that now by cutting in. But what we're going to do here as well is add some chips into the sides of the white lines here to make it look like the paint's chipping off. Just adding a few little chips like this here and there, just touching them in like so. There we go, those small chips applied, that's the white stripe complete. Okay, up next, have a look at painting the black leather of our ogre's boots. And for this, we'll start off with a base coat of Abaddon Black. We'll then highlight that with Eschen Grey before highlighting it with Dawnstone over the top. First of all, that base coat of Abaddon Black. And for this, because it's such a small detail, again, we're using our small airbrush. Again, grab a bit of paint from the pots onto the palette. As always, a little bit of water here to help smooth out that paint, make sure it goes on real nice. Load up the brush, then onto our ogre. Here, a nice base coat of Abaddon Black all over the boots. Now, as you're applying this, be super careful not to hit any of the parts we've already painted. So in particular, the metal and the skin that we've already done. Just make sure you're taking your time. That's why we're using a small airbrush here for added control, so we can do stuff like this. Once the base coat is applied, now we're applying a highlight. First is Eschen Grey. Again, we're using our small airbrush here just to pick out the very edges of the leather here. Remember, the thinner the highlights, the better this will look. So be as super careful as you can here. Then over the top of this, we're applying a highlight of thinned down Dawnstone here, just being super fine to hit just the very edges of the black leather. There we go, that's the black leather painted. All right, next up, let's have a look at those straps around our ogre's legs and arms. And for this, we'll start with a base coat of Rakarth Flesh. We'll then shade those down with Agrax Earthshade before highlighting them all with Pallid Witch Flesh. First of all, that base coat of Rakarth Flesh. For this, grab your medium layer brush. Again, a little bit of paint from the pot like so. Just a touch of water. There we go, bingo. Then onto our ogre. Here now, we're applying this onto the straps that are going around his legs and around his arms. So just take your time here to just pick them out carefully and be real sure not to any other parts of the model you've already painted. Next up on the straps, it's a wash of Agrax Earthshade. Here I've added a little bit of water to it to thin it down a little bit so it goes on nice and subtle. I'm just painting it out over all the straps on both the arms and the legs. Once that's dry, we're applying a sharp edge highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh to the straps here. Just being very careful to just hit the very edges here and just bring it around nice and neat like this. There we go, the straps are painted in and our ogre is almost done. There's just one thing left to do, of course, and that's to paint a textured base onto our model to make it look like he's on the astrogranite of a Blood Bowl pitch. Now for ours, we'll be using a Gorillon Earth texture paint, a crackle paint, and once that's dry and crackled, we'll then apply a wash over the top with Agrax Earthshade. Then we'll dry brush over the top of that lightly with Terminator's Stone before applying Corax White to make it look like a pitch line. First of all, it's the Gorillon Earth, and here we can apply it using our medium base brush. Let's grab some paint from the pot like so. We're just going to load our brush straight up from the pot, then onto our miniature. Here we're applying a nice heavy layer of Agrellan Earth all over the top of our base like so. We're not going too thick, but a nice heavy layer like this is perfect. And just make sure when you're getting near the feet of your miniature, you're taking extra time to make sure it doesn't hit the model itself. Allow about an hour for this to fully dry, and once it has, it'll be time for the next stage. Once that's dry and the paint's all crackled, next up we're applying a layer of Agrax Earthshade over the top of it like this to shade it down. Once the wash is dry, now it's a dry brush of Terminator's Stone over the top using a small dry brush. Here it's just quite a light dry brush, just picking up the very, very tips and ridges of that crackle paint. Next up, to make our base even more Blood Bowl themed, we're just going to add a white line across the base like this using Korax White. There we go, that's a nice thick white line painted on the base. Now we're going to add some more texture to our base using some tufts. These are Middenland tufts available from Games Workshop, and when they arrive they come on a plastic backing like this. To remove and apply them, all we're going to do is take our pair of Citadel fine detail cutters. Then take one of the tufts from the backing like so. Just lift it up with those fine detail cutters like this. Then onto the base of your miniature, which is going to apply it on like so. Now these are self-adhesive, so they'll just stick onto the base like this. I'm going to add maybe three or four to make our base look really turfy. And once that's done, I'll paint the rim of the base with a Baden black. There we go, with the tufts applied and the rim painted a Baden black, our base is finished. And with that, the Fire Mountain Gutbusters Ogre Blocker is complete and ready for the pitch. Remember, you can use these same techniques to paint all the ogres in your team. And that's how you can paint your Fire Mountain Gutbusters Ogres. A couple of things to remember here. When you're applying your paints, always try and take your time and be as neat as you possibly can. It's really worth spending a bit of extra time to ensure you don't make any mistakes. But if you do, don't worry, you can always go back and correct them. Second of all, when you're applying large areas of wash or contrast paint to areas such as the flesh or the shorts in this video, make sure you're moving those paints around and they're not pooling together in the recesses. Doing that means they won't dry too patchy. Hope you've enjoyed the video. They think it's all ogre. It is now.